things that he needs to do to help his team win, and really just run the plays that we call, and he'll have every opportunity to achieve the very highest level. And certainly the greatest credential of a Heisman Trophy candidate is a very successful team.
Coach, the last two games in Baton Rouge, it's come down to the last drive, and they've been able to get it done. As you prepare for this game, or even the season, was there a lot more time spent on defense in those situations? And if it comes down to that again, how much better prepared do you think you are than maybe you were a year ago?
Well, I think it's something that we've really focused on, and we'll focus on again today. It's an awfully important piece to really any game. You know, a 2 minute drive before the half, or a 2 minute drive at the end of the game for victory. And we kind of went through those scenarios pretty routinely, really from spring on. So it's not something there's no void in the coaching there. I think they executed extremely well.
Coach, at the back here, when you turn on the video and look at Alabama's defense, number one against the run, number one sacking quarterbacks, getting after quarterbacks, what stands out more to you? Is it the individual battles that they're winning, or is it the scheme and the outnumbering people?
No, I think it's I think they've done a very good job with scheme, but I think it's more they've put very talented men in the right position. They're seldom out of place, and they're in a position to make a tackle when they generally do.
Mel here, question about offensive line. How much do you think the ability to recruit, build a big, strong offensive line influences the way teams like you and Alabama and even Florida this year play, and diminish maybe the need to follow the spread out?
I think the spread offense is a tremendous way to move the football. I have no problem doing it whatsoever. It's just a piece of something that we do, and we enjoy the fact that there's physicality to the style of offense that we run. We're going to challenge a defense and try to control the line of scrimmage and block them. And it's not necessarily pass-only event. I think that's how our offense is built. I think we'll stay there.
What's on the backside of that? Defensively, does this game force you to kind of keep your defense honest? As Brett said, everybody's moving to spread attacks, but this one particular game usually is a power game and run-oriented contest. And in that nature, I guess, does Kendall Beckwith help, in this specific game?
Explain that. I didn't hear the last piece.
Most of the year, you're defending spread offense. This year, you have to really kind of load up in front. Does this game keep you honest when you're picking your personnel, when you're trying to figure out who will be in the game? And does Kendall play a large part of it?
Gotcha. Yeah, when you line up against a spread attack, there is a tendency to want to play a little bit more nickel, a little bit more lighter athletic guys. It's kind of one of those things that we choose. We're looking for that long angular athletic person, and Kendall Beckwith certainly fits that. He has to be strong and capable, but he's also one of the faster guys on the team, and so he would fit that dual bill. He got to stand in against a power running attack, also have the athleticism to stop the gun.